Alright guys, how's it going? Today we are going to at least start Steyliff Grove Vault. I say start because I don't know if I'll actually be able to finish it today in one sitting. But it is right here at the Cave Investor Pool. And I believe that it is 100 floors. We will be getting the Balgmog Sword, an Aegis Shield, and the Flare Polearm. So, yeah, here we go, and this is the, one of the dungeons that you could only enter at night. So, around 19, it will open for you, and you can actually go in. And then, like always, just work your way down until you hit the vault, and then go from there. I'm not gonna lie, this dungeon kind of messed with me at first with the falling stuff and it keeping treasures from you. How's it going over there, castaway?
What can I say?
Funny, I can see that you're in the chat room, yet it doesn't show me that there's anyone watching right now.
You're on fire today!
Game's up.
Huh, I don't think that was supposed to go up right there. Glad to hear you're doing great, castaway. Yeah, just like normal, go ahead and work your way down. Killing things as you go, you know how it goes.
Don't be late. Immaculate.
We're on the same page.
I just got slapped by Jelly. Sure, I'll run past them. I believe I needed to fight those guys to interact with this, though. Yet another ledge just purely there to slow you down. I mean, that's ultimately the path that you need to go on, and that's upsetting. Anyway. Got some more skeletons. But Castaway doesn't want me to fight them, so on we go. Hey, have you done Pitios yet, Castaway?
How many times?
Enough talk. Time for some action.
Prayers.
I did that one yesterday, I think. And it legitimately took me like 8 hours. I mean, maybe more like 4 hours of actual gameplay. But it freaking sucked. It was so hard. Like, I'm not a platform guy. Freaking hate doing platformers. Like, I've always hated Mario type games. And that was like putting Mario on crack and throwing it in a 3D world. Yeah, other than speedruns, I haven't really heard of anyone doing it in anything less than 2.5 hours. So, from my knowledge, you are just about average, if not perfectly average, on that time. And you're right, this game is not made for platforming. I mean, it got so bad for me that in a couple of different areas, I was like, okay, how could I use the speedrun tactics to get through this section? Like, I did every dungeon room, puzzle room, if you want to call it that, But there were just places that I just couldn't make it to. But for some reason, I was able to do the speedrun shit and just made it easier.
Nox rules!
No big deal.
And after this vault, we actually only have one more vault to do. And that is going to be Coastal Mark with the level 99 recommendation and no item uses. So that's going to be interesting. Yeah, and I didn't really use a quote-unquote guide for it either. Everything I found online were speedruns and stuff. So, if I got to a part that I just couldn't understand, I saw what people were doing online, and it was mostly speedruns. And I was like, okay, well that's vaguely annoying, but I could use that to make it on and continue doing each particular puzzle. The room that really messed me up was the room with the statue of that lady. I just couldn't get down the timing for the various, what's it called, jumps onto the platforms. Has he yet to make that key into that hole? Yes, Castaway, I'm pretty sure this is the 100 floor dungeon. We have this one and then the one without any item usage.
Hey, it's open!
Let's hit it.
And we are going to try to get down as far as we can right now. I might need to cut it short a little bit, depending on when my roommates get home. But hopefully we'll be able to make it. If not, I'll go live again later tonight and finish it up once they go to sleep.
Hey, where'd you learn that one, Nox?
Nothing to it.
Yeah, I know, I'm gonna be doing this for a while. But I'm hoping I could do it in less than like 4 hours.
Never knew what hit him.
This shouldn't take long.
I mean, I'm cool doing it for an hour, 2 hours. But I don't think I can actually stream for longer than 2 hours. Alright, so right there was an iron shaving. And I continue going down. Plus more Havoc Fangs. I've heard of people doing, like, it taking people about 2 hours to finish this, but knowing my luck when it comes to actually recording, it might take me a little bit longer.
None the worse for wear.
Bring on the next one.
And yeah, there's something like two or three separate actual dungeon bosses going down this one, if I remember what I heard correctly. So yeah, that might have been confusing for you. Oh, you said to make sure there was an end. Yeah, that makes sense. I mean, seeing as how all the other ones were, like, what, 10, 15 floors? Maybe 20? Alright, Psychomancer right here is going to be weak to ice. But its health is kind of high, so that's going to be a while. Now, did he purposely do this one first, or did he just find yourself in it?
Watch yourself, Noct. No.
So what all are the Psychomancers weak to? They are weak to Greatsword, Shields, Ice, and Light. So, I suppose I should do what I normally do. And have that equipped. It was the closest once finishing the game. Well, I mean, it is right there, literally right down the street from where you get the key, so that makes sense. But that parry, you literally need to hit X and B at like the same time, don't you?
No mercy.
There we go.
Yeah.
Or a mithril shaft.
Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo! We're alive. Let's celebrate by eating something dead.
I don't know if you want to eat that thing. Just saying, Prompto. I think it might have been human at one point in time. I mean, technically, according to the story, all the demons were humans at one point in time, right?
None the worse for wear.
Anyway, just keep going, going, going.
How should we do this, Noct?
Ah.
Do whatever.
Okay. So, have I passed any of the doors with four rooms?
Look where you're going.
Oh, sorry about that.
Or the rooms with four doors. I think I said that backwards the first time. I believe the Balgmond is in one of those offshoot rooms, is it not? If I have passed one, I'm only a couple floors down, so I could easily go back and get it.
That was a close one.
Too close for comfort.
I'm comfortable just being alive.
I want to show something. Hold on. Find this actually kind of funny. This is almost purely just Gladiolus picking up coins in battle. I have damn near 60 rare coins right now. At level 99.
Temper and temper.
When I saw that, I almost laughed, or I actually did laugh, but I almost freaking spit up whatever it was I was drinking at the time. Yes, I'm going to kill you and turn you into stone in the same move. Yeah, I started XP grinding in chapter 3. but I went full out on it with those coins in like chapter 8, so I've used maybe like 24 of them. And then I found out that you could farm the cockatrice crest relatively easily for some easier experience cast. Come on. Come on. There you go. No mercy. Gladly. And she was guarding a mega elixir. And we come across another psychomancer.
That was close. Don't die on me.
Yeah, I've ended up getting something like, I don't know, 40 or 50 iron ingots, but I seldom want to hit 10. Hey, look, I did it! Those psychomancers are annoying with their stone.
How are we?
Goodbye. I'm only seeing one door in this room. It might be the next one though. Almost got this guy down.
That's crossing the line. Sorry.
Alright. Got a moon pendant from him. And a potion on the floor.
We're alive! Let's celebrate by eating something dead.
Apparently Prompto's just really in cannibalism.
You want to make camp?
Okay, so it's going to be the next one that has multiple exits. Well, that would explain something right there. Running. And as per usual, the Ronin ain't too hard to take down.
Put it in the box. It's history now.
Oh, I saw someone had an enemy glitch, like, behind one of these gates, like, in the wall, and they just, for whatever reason, couldn't kill the little guy. They were stuck in one of these rooms. Had to, reload. Sure, that pissed them off. Here we go, here's our first, multiple room. Take out the little fluffy demon dog thingies. They were guarding a purified salt. And according to my guide, we are supposed to be using that one right there. I'm going to go with this one. Or a potion right there. And let's see what's over here. Whatever the heck that is. Ah. Okay. Guards you against elements. I believe we picked up something on the in the last vault that guarded against all the elements as well. How the hell did you make it down here?
Hey! No! Whatever that is, it's disgusting. What's ya?
Yeah, I honestly didn't really like the Justice Monster 5 machine. I only used it to get the Dark Matter. And even then, I didn't really enjoy it. Soul sucking thing is annoying.
Bronco, stop bitching, start killing.
Hey, look, he summoned little skeletons. Not what I'm meaning to strike. I really am holding to parry this. I don't know why I have so much freaking trouble with that. Come on. There we go. He's down. He was guarding a chrome bit.
By eating something dead.
And in the next room, we have another psychomancer. Like, seriously, I parried, then I pressed, or I blocked and pressed parry, and it just didn't do anything. That was my fault for jumping into that one. And good, there we go. Wasn't pulling that up for a second. Watch out. And should be dead momentarily. There we go. And that psychomancer was guarding another bangle, which gives you 1200 health.
Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo! We're alive! Let's celebrate by eating something dead!
Really starting to think that Prompto is a cannibal.
Remember, easy as they come.
And now!
I did not realize these guys cast confusion, or caused confusion.
There's no use hanging around here.
A debased coin right there. Down to the next floor. Are some more Ronin. Ow. Oh, that makes sense, and I appreciate that. Thank you. Use that one. Look at that, he's killed them. Okay. I'm gonna go with this one. I forget which one I came out of, which apparently was that one. And going down here.
Next thing I need now. Eyes peeled, mouth closed.
No. Come on.
That's crossing the
line. This one's just for you. Yeah.
Nothing to it.
Those Havoc Fangs were guarding a high potion. Keep going down. Got another psychomancer down here. I want. Nope.
Watch out.
Know what? Why not? There, I think that got him.
We're alive. Let's celebrate.
Make elixir.
Dead.
I did it again. On to the next room. For some more Ronin. Take care of my guys.
I lost you for a second.
Wait, do I have three in here? Alright. I clicked the wrong one. Oops. Another four.
I'm starving to death.
All right.
And yet we're all very much alive.
They gave me another mega potion. Continue going down. Come across another campsite. All right.
And here we are.
This should be a mega elixir. Yep, there we go. Keep going down.
Not a fan of mushy desserts.
Now these guys are like any other flan. They are or should be resistant to normal physical attack. But the Royal Arms should take care of them relatively easily.
Let's go.
Yep.
And they're guarding a iron shaving. The next room, we have some more Ronin.
Enough talk. Time for some action.
Nothing close, move.
Yeah, I mean, I'm pretty sure if the smart tactic on those guys would have been to use Royal Arms, or would have been to use spells, but I didn't want to burn through my freeze spell just right then, so I decided to give it a shot with the Royal Arm, and it actually worked.
Let's do this. Okay.
No quarter.
Yeah.
No use hanging around here.
Indeed.
Well, there you go. We learn something new every day. I am 100% sure, though, that the Royal Arms do not work on the custards. I know that for a fact. I tried it, and it did nothing. So the only way to kill the custards are with spells.
Farewell.
Speaking of custards, are there any in here? Yes, there are. There are custards in here. Fun. Got another Psychomancer.
Stop bitching, start killing.
You know what? I just want to petrify this guy. Like, he keeps petrifying me, I want to petrify him. Is that too much to ask? Guess unloading this on him will have to do. There we go. And this way.
We're alive. Let's celebrate by eating something dead.
And down we go.
What?
They won't know what hit them.
My hero.
And on we go.
Right.
They literally didn't even know it hit them. Alright, so here we are going to be taking the middle path again. So, over here first. For a debased coin. Then, over here. Or a high potion. And on we go. So can you guys see when I get little private messages from people? Do they pop up over there? Seriously? Alright, cool. Keep on forgetting that the royal arms hurt me. That's how often I use royal arms. I mean, not to mention the fact that I parried this guy and yet he still breaks through. Don't die. Hey, I made it. Alright, so I suppose I can leave it there and not really use it unless I'm... I wonder. Yeah, you don't even need to use royal arms on these guys. So it must have been the custards that you were thinking about. Make sure. Yep. On we go.
He's got a knife.
Oh, goody.
Don't bet on it.
Tom Berries. What are these regular Tomberries weak to? They are weak to daggers, firearms, and ice. I know I should be blocking and parrying. I don't know, my brain doesn't work that way for some reason. So yeah, those guys are weak to ice. And look what you get for killing those guys. Get that right there. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to equip that.
Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo! We're alive! Let's celebrate by eating something dead!
Alright.
We're here.
And this room should be like an elixir or something like that. Hi, elixir. Cheeky bastards. Every other dungeon, they made the point in those little campsites, but this one, they made it others. What? Oh. I still don't know how any of these monsters are supposed to eat down here.
Nothing we can't handle.
Oh, come on, you're baby chickens. You gotta eat something sometime. What do you eat?
Right.
And there were tonberries literally two rooms up there. Does not seem safe. And then there were killer bees right here.
What's the idea?
Anyway. Did I pick up the item that was in that room? I don't remember if I did. Those guys are guarding an Oracle Ascension coin. Oh, I know I'm gonna have loads of fun with the Sir Tomberries later down. I don't know, it might just be that I like subjecting myself to pain and misery. But I've always enjoyed fighting Tonberries. I have no clue why. I first encountered them in the Cavern of the Stolen Faith in Final Fantasy X, and I've loved them ever since then. There's just something oddly wonderful about how terrifying they are. Not to mention they're like one of the only creatures that hasn't changed at all, like design style, in any of the games. Every once in a while they'll change color here and there, but they're basically exactly the same. Kill those guys, and you will get a chrome bit. Because I'm sure you're gonna need a chrome bit this late in the game. Oh, Castaway. Like, the day after you told me that I was going to mess up my experience banking, I messed up my experience banking. And I was so pissed off. Like, I had almost 2 million experience saved up. And then all because I forgot to freaking equip something. All gone. I need to finish Rurouni Kenshin. That was some amazing show. It's on Netflix, I just haven't finished it.
Your clothes are filthy.
And so are yours.
Well, oh, a load of laundry.
I broke them. Go ahead, laugh it up, buddy.
Right.
I blame you for telling me that I was going to do it.
Mouth closed.
another show that I used to watch when I was younger was Zoids. I just remember that show like a week ago, and I was like, I wonder if that's on Netflix. It's not. So I checked Hulu. It's not on Hulu. And yeah, the only way I could watch it is in like a box within a box on YouTube. And yes, you were right. I did mess up with my experience. Alright, they were guarding a potion. More little, birds. Why am I not getting attacked? That was weird. Kill the birds. I mean, they really shouldn't be all that strong anyway, because they should be starving to death. But that's neither here nor there.
Glad you were there.
They're guarding an elixir.
I'm starving to death.
And yet we're all very much alive.
Alright. What, grab that? Going to equip that. And I'm going to rest because my thing's about to run out and might as well. Thank you for reminding me to do it, Mr. Castaway. At least I'm assuming you're a guy. I don't know why I just assumed that. I think we had the same conversation last time. I just assumed. Any good pictures? Probably not.
The heck? This one's pretty good.
I know. I dig it too.
Yeah, I'm going crit food. I always go crit food. Because it gives me the guaranteed critical as well as 150% health regeneration. There it is. No, that wasn't it. I passed it. There we go.
Time to go.
And on we go.
Right behind you.
I freaking did it again. This guy's weak to pole arms and shields, apparently. Stop.
We all good.
Better than good.
Good to go.
He was guarding another useless rusted bit. And we got some more flan dudes down here.
Yeah!
Yeah, I know anyone could have it equipped. I just... I don't know. I don't like having something equipped permanently that's not going to do anything during my actual fighting. I don't know, I'm just weird like that. Got some more green jello down here.
With this
review. Where'd he go? There it is.
You're on fire today.
What can I say? Nothing to it.
He's got a knife. Maybe it's for
you, sneaky bastard. I even knew you were there. I was holding X. Am I doing 9,000 damage on that parry? That's actually kind of amusing. Now he doesn't want to attack me. Come on. There we go. Why is this guy only doing like 7,000 when the other one was 9,000? There he goes. Yeah, that's a great strategy with Tom Berries. Thank you, Castaway, for reminding me to do it.
We're alive! Let's celebrate by eating something.
Block parry, block parry, block parry. I really don't know how these non-demon creatures don't die of malnutrition.
Nothing to it.
All in a day's work.
Really, can these giant chickens even make it through the door? Got an Oracle Ascension coin right there.
The kitchen. Don't die on me.
Aha, I saw that one coming. So apparently they can still break through from time to time, but... Okay, come on. Come on. Come on. Well, that was annoying. Oh, fireball. I've honestly never seen one of them throw a fireball.
On top of it.
Let's put it out of its misery.
Swift and painful.
Get it out.
I hit it. Oh well.
Of course.
This should do it. Got a high potion right there.
Magnificent.
We're alive. Celebrate by eating something dead.
Some more jello.
Chop chop.
I don't even kill the monster and they struck a pose. Alright.
Right.
The jello was guarding an anklet of something. Of the gods, 450 vitality. Keep going down. Got some more tomberries in here, and I'm out of ice spells. No. I will use Blair. Why? Because I hate myself.
This doesn't look too good.
Quite a formidable fool.
Get back.
Is this the room that you were just trying to warn me about? What is with that fireball? Come on. I was about to say 43. Did I really miscount that bad? Oh, I'm stopped. That's annoying. But it lets me revive my whole party again. Out a cheap Tonberry. I believe they're weak to machinery, weren't they? Yeah, firearms is what I meant.
Ready to take on the world.
Alright.
I'm impressed.
It's nothing.
Get lost. Nice save.
Bomber just got stabbed in the back.
That was close.
Come on. Come on. I didn't even realize my whole team was dead right there. Just focused on parrying and dodging and parrying and dodging.
Gladio.
I can barely feel anything anymore.
Say
your prayers.
I know.
One last push to finish them off.
Kill the Tomberry. Come on. And there we go. That fight took a little bit longer and had me using a little bit more brain power than I'm used to. And all I got was an iron shaving.
We're alive! Let's celebrate by eating something dead!
Alright.
We're here.
We got a mega elixir right there. Continue going down.
Let me give the orders this time.
That's not orders, Ignis. That's just what we normally do. Alright, we've got another crest right there. Not that I'll actually be doing any Xperia casts anytime soon, but still like to get those little crests. A mithril shaft is what that was guarding. And continue on down. To take on a killer wasp. Apparently two killer wasps. Right, got some elixirs right there. Yeah, I'm just not quick enough on the whole button pressing to make that Tomberry thing look as good as it actually is. But I know that that is the way to take on a big old room of Tomberries. Got another debased banknote. Got another rooster right here. Which Ignis apparently poisoned. I mean, that's one hell of a way to go. Get poisoned and then get a piece of your head broken off and just relentless assault from two pokey, slicey things. That would have sucked. No, I only got two Tomberries this time. Alright. Come on. Come on. I wonder if I could take out these Tomberries with the Ring of the Lucii. That'd be entertaining.
Sorry.
I mean, I know the ones that you face in the regular world. Yeah, I know that the Tomberries facing the overworld, if you will, you could take out with the Ring of the Lucii. But I wonder if you can with these guys, too.
Whoops. This can't be.
Not on top of it! Ha!
Darn it, I want the ring to work. Why are you running away from me?
Yeah, I knew what you meant. Thank you. Thank you for letting me know that you just don't have enough MP to kill them.
Gladio!
Nart, back me up!
I don't want to back you up. You back me up.
He's a nice guy.
Try this on your side.
He was vulnerable. I felt safe attacking him.
Of course.
Yes, let's do our little dance and miss our target.
Counter.
One last push should suffice to finish them off.
I'm fine.
Alright, there we go.
Hell yeah!
Impeccable.
They're guarding a mega potion. And don't go the way you came in from. Go the other way. I wonder. No, no, not that. I wonder what sort of damage this will do. I mean, ultimately not bad, but not enough. I mean, I would hope I'll be proficient at it with how many tomberries it looks like I'll be running into.
Gotcha. Rush him. Count on it.
Yeah, come on. Attack me. I wonder if I'll even kill. Hey, I killed one. I wonder if I can kill two. Nope.
Okay.
Let's sped it up at least a little bit. So is this anything like the Tomberry Tower that was in Final Fantasy X last mission? So I never actually played that.
That was close.
I actually forgot that I had that skill. Or if you get hit and then you phase right after you get hit, you recover your health.
Appreciate it.
That was close. Ain't got much life left in it.
Let's finish this.
Show no mercy.
Gladly.
Come on. Come on. Attack me, you little fucker.
All over.
I'll do sage fire with your knife. There you go. Now, Iggy, you can get off. You can get up off the floor now. Hey, look, a platinum ingot.
Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo! We're alive. Let's celebrate by eating something dead.
What was that grunt for? Alright, now on to the next room. Got some killer bees or wasps. Raise my strength a little bit more.
Knocked. Appreciate it.
Thank you for the tip, Castaway. I could equip some black chokers to help up the health regen in between rooms. I don't know why I don't. Would that stack on top of the 150% from the food? Like, does it... Would it be possible to get it up to, like, 500%? Well, maybe not 500, but... Really? Huh. Alright, I might have to look into that. That is not the right thing. These are not the wyverns I am used to fighting. Now with that, get it back up from... Like the blackness. Why do I keep on using that? Like, will you be able to recover your maximum health points, or does it just go to wherever the new maximum is? Why are these wyverns so much stronger? I mean, I know why they're so much stronger. Okay, so it is just a new maximum? Okay. That makes sense. Check it out at some point.
Watch
yourself. Certainly didn't expect this much.
Watch this!
Doesn't look good.
Dragons.
Even our best deal isn't good enough.
Not with that attitude, is it?
Say your prayers.
This guy should be going down relatively soon. And there we go.
Something to look forward to.
And there we get the shield. Which gives you some more vitality and bullet resistance.
Impressive.
So, I want to see something. Do I even have a black choker? I do. That's not what I meant to do. Darn it. Okay.
We're alive! Let's celebrate by eating something dead!
I know I should probably change that back to black, dark matter, but I'm not gonna do that right now. All right, now we've got some more jello to take care of down here. They do such a pretty dance, but never hit anyone.
Onward.
Right.
Got a chrome bit. And down to the next room. Got another Psychomancer. It's actually kind of hoping that we were done with these guys. Yeah, that's what I was thinking too. I mean, I remember it going up slowly outside of combat, outside of the dungeons. So I was hoping that it would work in here, but it's not. So that's whatever. Now here we're going to want to take the left path. Let's take every path but that left path. For a potion. And over here. You'll get a robe of the Lord. An accessory exclusive for Noct. It increases your MP recovery rate. Let's continue on down. So, we are a little over halfway if I counted my little boxes correctly. Aha! I dodged your petrification. If only I could hit you.
Yeah.
There we go.
One last push until I finish them off. That's crossing the line. Sorry.
Ready to go.
Quick and easy.
Close it out, Gladio.
All right.
Oh, yeah.
So that guy was guarding a mithril shaft. Got some more,
keep it together.
What are the guys actually called? Machua Moose, that is what they're actually called. I don't know, I like green jello better personally. Reminds me of green jello. They're guarding an Oracle Ascension coin. Killing these guys, get some more jello. Alright, those guys drop dark crests, by the way, which I believe guards against darkness. I mean, that would only make sense. Got another Psychomancer. Whoa!
Ain't got much life left in it.
The heck happened there?
Show no mercy.
Think I've ever killed one of those things that quickly.
Whose side are you on?
Oh, sorry about that.
I mean, what the hell? It's taking me longer to kill the Vortus than it took me longer to kill that thing. Carried it.
Was that perfect or what?
I'll give you that.
I think the Tomberry parrying quickened me up for that guy's parry. Continue on down the rabbit hole.
Not a fan of mushy desserts.
Out of the way! Say your prayers.
I just got body slammed by jello. I wonder how long this has been. I mean, it feels like 15-20 minutes to me, but I know that that's not right. It was probably close to like an hour, maybe an hour and a half.
Stay on your feet.
Of course,
Now you want to stay in the air.
Right there!
There we go. Those guys are carting an elixir. Down to the next floor we go. In this room we have a camp. Alright, so we have... After this camp we have two more camps and then... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8... We have about 16 more floors till the end. I believe, if I'm doing my mathematics correctly.
I'm going all out.
Okay.
Yeah. You want to tell us that?
Yep. Need a spell for these guys. There we go. They're guarding a rare coin. I wonder if the guys ever get pissed off at Noctis for casting a spell that fucks with them. Those two weren't that hard.
Onward.
Yep.
They're guarding a sky gemstone.
Let's move.
Yeah.
Yeah. We got multiple custards. They absorb lightning. Forgot about that. My bad. I'm an idiot. Come on. Come on. Come on. There we go. Except for now, I'm not going to be able to get out of this room because that... Hey, look, it went out really quick. Did I miss something, Castaway? Or are you saying nice to the fact that I only have a couple more rooms left?
Let's do
this. Alright, so yeah, the custards absorb lightning and the red ones absorb fire. If I'm not mistaken. Got it. Okay. So, I'm going to see. And I doubt these will actually do anything, but I don't want to waste a flare on just one custard.
Here goes nothing!
Okay.
Are you saying the Mind Flayers suck ass, or that the Custard guys suck ass? Whoa! I did not know that those guys did that. Got it. Yeah, the custards can be annoying. Especially when you cast a overpowered lightning spell at them and all they do is absorb it.
Come a long way, Prompto!
That was a close one. Those guys were guarding something that I can't pick up. They were guarding a potion. Then on the next floor, we got some more of these guys. Yeah, the custards and their red cousin are completely immune to physical damage. Doesn't matter if you have it with an element on it, they are completely immune to physical damage. So you have to use a spell. Like there is no way getting around it. Got an Oracle Ascension coin right there. Now these guys, I gotta switch over to my lightning spell. Let's see if I can lure them all into one place. That is a great question. Let's figure that out. That is the move they were talking about, right? The Libra Elemental. See if that one works.
Hey, Ignis! Instructions!
It's just the thing.
Alright, so it did some damage.
Gotcha.
Yeah. It was
just the thing.
Alright, nope. Doesn't work.
Try this on your side.
So yeah, you really do just have to cast magic at them.
Let's go.
Indeed.
I mean, I might run out of my high level spells, but I really don't think I'm gonna run out of magic anytime soon. I think the first throw did do some damage for whatever reason. I don't know if it just kind of linked in with like electricity that was still roaming the floor, but I don't know if you could rely on it. I mean, I'll try it again here without any sort of element on the ground. I believe he throws whatever element like they are weak to. Okay, so yeah, it does do damage to them. I don't know if it does damage all the time. Like, I don't know why that second throw up there didn't do anything. But so it does do something.
This can't be.
I just, like I said, I wouldn't personally rely on it.
You need to help Ignis.
Not good.
I don't need to help Ignis. Sure, he would like me to help him.
You all right?
Ignis! Be right over!
Thank you.
No biggie.
You okay, Specky?
I'm fine.
Ignis!
I've just the thing.
One. Got it. You didn't have any spells. You came unprepared. Oh yeah, that's right. You didn't know what dungeon you were getting into. That blows. I'm sorry. Yeah, I didn't know exactly what I was getting into, but I knew that it was going to be a interesting dungeon going down here tonight.
Ugh, I'm all sticky and gross.
Woohoo! Bath time!
Prompto, where are you guys going to take a bath down here? So what would you suggest I do as my food, senor? I mean, this one might be cool. Increase attack by 400, increase maximum HP by 2000. No. Saying same, so I'm assuming that that means this. Yep, okay. You questioned me the first time, and apparently something that I did made you understand why I was doing it. I just like the guaranteed critical and the 150% health regeneration. What do you mean, was? We're still freaking in here. Alright. Let me go ahead and put this black choker back on.
I'm good to go.
Just about awake.
Huh? Every time? Okay. That makes sense. Sorry that I thought that you were questioning me instead of asking me if that's the one that I did.
He's got a knife! Maybe it's for cooking?
Don't bet on it.
I don't trust this guy.
I'm fine! Yeah. Stay alive.
One shot!
I mean, I'm gonna kill him and he's gonna rez as like a freaking, what's it called? Sir Tomberry, something like that. I just don't trust him being alone.
barely.
Yeah.
Magnificent.
I mean, why just a single Tonberry?
That took everything we had.
Why just one?
You should be proud you gave it your all.
I've got nothing left.
Oh, whatever that is, it's disgusting.
Cut your behind.
I'll cover.
Yeah, I know that there is at least one room down here with at least one Sir Tonberry. Oh no, it's a Master Tonberry down here. That's gonna be difficult. But the strategy in theory should just be the same. Dodge, parry, dodge, parry.
Knocked. Does tired count?
Another coin.
Don't die on me.
Aw, it clipped me. I mean, I might have been right in the middle of it, but still. I've been avoiding that for a couple fights now. He was guarding a Mega Phoenix. And Master Tonberry. Nope, just two regular Tonberries. Almost killed one of them with that.
Glad you.
I owe you.
Oh, come on. I was holding it. I do not trust you, Mr. Tonberry. Did this guy not get hit a single time during that chain? Anywho. Like how Nog is just looking down on him.
My bad.
Coming up.
This can't be.
Ain't got much life left in it.
Nothing
goes. No mercy.
Gladly.
No mercy.
All right. He is down.
I even amaze myself sometimes.
Your ego.
He was guarding a high elixir.
Frankly, I'm just amazed we actually made it.
We've got another Psychomancer down here.
Yeah.
really need to keep an eye on these guys. Yeah, it seems like going around his head like this is the way to go when attacking the Psychomancer. Because he's not going to be able to grab you, he's not going to be able to petrify you, and he'll go down relatively quickly. Like that.
Back to it.
And he had a ether for you. And continue down to the next room. For some more Tomberries.
Don't bet on it.
Yeah, I'm on.
One time.
Sure thing.
I thought.
Wait, is this a waste? Maybe. Still an easy way to bring down at least one of their health.
That was close.
I'm fine.
Well, here we
gotcha.
Are.
Oh, on top of it.
Hey, look, they actually hit. Lulls me into a false sense of security where I think I can attack him.
Just a little further and we got this.
Don't go dying on me.
Like he'll sit there not doing anything for a couple seconds and like, oh, I got this. And then I go to attack and he's like, haha, you dead.
Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo! We're alive! Let's celebrate by eating something dead!
I will answer that question for you, Castaway, as soon as I am done with this fight.
One last push, suffice to finish them off.
Alright, so his question was, do you have the Link Strike Limit Break unlocked? I have literally everything inside of here unlocked. So yes, I have the limit break unlocked.
Oh yeah.
Why do you ask? Before I hit chapter 9, I completely leveled myself and did a lot of
aiming.
I honestly didn't even see the number of that prompto strike. What was it?
Mind if I do? Stick around, Gladio. The fun's just started.
My bad.
Got it. Oh, 10,000?
Thought we lost you for a second.
Yeah, come on. Or 8,000? Stop running away from me.
Look at you.
Wonder what this will do. I mean, I've definitely seen it do a lot more.
On top of it.
This is no time for a nap.
Did he miss?
Sorry for the trouble.
One false move and we're done for.
We can turn the tide yet.
Rush him! Count it! Say your prayers.
Certainly didn't expect this much trouble.
Yeah, that impulse is completely maxed out. Or max level. But, so, I believe it's only level 2.
Iggy's looking pretty rough.
Don't you go quitting on me.
Wouldn't dare.
Of course.
And thank you for saying that I'm hitting a rhythm. It is actually really hard for me not to just, like, attack them. Yeah, I really do enjoy that impulse of his. Trying to separate, but they keep on coming to
Stick
me.
Around, Gladio. The bunch just started.
My bad.
Gladio, do it.
Any last words?
Right there.
Ouch, did I say 38,000? I'm just gonna leave him dead. Oh, I know what's going on. My bad. No, I was doing so good.
Yeah, Ignis.
Of course.
Thanks for that.
Pay it no mind.
Ignis.
My pleasure.
Come on, someone attack. Why are they running away from me?
Ignis!
Of course.
Isn't it a bit,
get attacked? There we go.
Here I go! Up again.
Yeah.
All right. Well, that was fun. Got a another purified salt.
I want to just flop onto a hotel bed.
Cannonball for me.
Camp's not gonna cut it tonight.
Yes, one benefit of a completely dead team is the unlimited 9,999 damage parries.
He's got a knife! Maybe it's for-
Hey, look! Little Yoda!
My bad.
Wait, did I really get an A-plus finesse on that one? I wasn't even looking.
Whatever doesn't kill me, it makes me stronger!
Not what I told you to do!
Pronto! Mind if I do?
Not. Help Iggy.
Not good.
I don't want to help Iggy.
Ignis!
Not. Back me up!
Bring on the Master Tonberry. Vulnerable. Attack.
Pronto, you're up.
So now Gladio's down, so this should start speeding up at least a little bit.
Nice one, Pronto. Knocked on top of it.
Good job, you blue little Yoda dude. Oh, come on, why'd you stop? I wonder if he's getting upset that I'm taking his own attacks and damaging him. And he's like literally not able to touch me. There we go. He gave me 15,000 experience. Alright.
Celebrate by eating something dead.
Now here's hoping that this next one is a camp. It is. Definitely cheap, definitely easy.
You wanna make camp?
I'm all sticky and gross.
Alright, so after this, I should only have 4 more levels till I hit the final one. No! Alright, this one it is. Not as good, but shouldn't be an issue for me. So now this way, once we put this back on.
Rest. Well,
The tent lets you stretch out a bit more.
Pick up that mega elixir right there, and don't go up the wrong one.
Ready for this?
Oh look, another Master Tomberry. I rested because of this last fight.
Iggy's looking pretty rough.
Should have known that there was gonna be at least one more Master Tomberry.
Gotcha! Bronco! Mind if I do?
Yeah, man. Yeah, man. You know, I probably could use this tactic for the two Sir Tomberry fight or Randolph. Instead, I somehow summon Leviathan. Still not sure how I summon Leviathan in that fight. Yeah, I didn't realize you could do this till like literally 20 minutes after recording my double Sir Tomberry fight. I was like, oh well, that would have been easier.
Going for it.
I mean, it didn't even cross my mind.
Brilliant.
And there we go. He drops a red choker. And he was guarding a useless chrome bit. Alright, so it's gonna be nothing but Master Tomberries for the rest of the place. Not that I would mind if it was. I just like at least a little bit of variety.
Watch out!
God, no, give me a random Flareus or something like that.
My pleasure.
We need you or another Mind Flare.
Where'd
he go?
Thanks would be nice.
I just want to see what this will do against him. Not too bad. I believe I saw a 28 and a 27. 1,000. His Sage Fire is the best individual damage for this guy, or just in general. Well then, let me put that on him.
Magnus!
Alright, so it's just in general. Okay. I don't know why I just stopped using Sage Fire for whatever reason. And instead I just went back down to Enhance or whatever it's called. Well, that was mean. Master Tom Berry is down. Guarding a high elixir.
We're alive. Let's
let me guess. Oh no, it's not a Master Tom Berry. It's a King Atrice. Like, I guess I get my desire for a little variety. Are you saying that Sage Fire did 30,000 damage against Angelus? Because if so, that is crazy.
Yep.
Oh, against that Tomberry. Got it.
What? Apologies.
Yeah, that's why I was confused, because I was under the impression that I would have done nothing against Angelus. So when I saw 30,000 damage, I only remember seeing like 20,000 damage done to the Tomberry. Like, from the Sage Fire, so I didn't know you were talking about the Tomberry. Yeah, I only saw it hit twice at that 10,000. I'm just holding X. How come sometimes it breaks through and sometimes it doesn't?
All better?
My bad.
All
Gotcha!
On cover!
Good as new! We still got a chance here!
Don't go dying on me now!
And he's down.
Yeah.
With a Centurion Bangle that increases your health by 1,000. What does that Red Choker do? Does the HP recovery rate?
We're alive. Let's celebrate by eating something dead.
Now this way. King Atrice. Yeah, that red choker is going to be worse than black. Honestly, I just saw that it had the little explanation point. I forgot what it was until I went back and looked at it.
Can't stop not.
What can I say?
We all good?
Better than good.
Good to go.
All right, now this way. And I'm guessing that we're coming across the final boss. Can I not use these outside of battle? Apparently.
How many times?
Enough talk. Time for some action.
Hello.
Oh, it's a griffin. Did not realize that there's gonna be a griffin down here. Brilliant idea, bud. Thank you. No, don't fly away on me, you asshole. What if he wasn't talking about the coffee? Alright, now he is down.
Impeccable.
Oracle Ascension coin. Now where the hell on here does it say that there's a griffin? Oh, there it is.
By eating something dead.
Darn it. Alright. Explains why the room was so big.
Last thing I need now.
Eyes peeled, not closed.
No.
Always hear something.
him.
All right. One of the few times I'll actually use a remedy right there. Got a debased banknote.
Okay.
Gotta be getting close to this final boss.
Really? Again?
That griffin never stood a chance.
Woo-hoo-hoo! We're alive! Let's celebrate by eating something dead!
In the next room, we got another King Atrice. I really am just going around in circles, aren't I? Griffin, King Atrice, Griffin, King Atrice. Go down to the next room, and I'm guessing another griffin. No. Hey, look, there he is. Oh, it's a quaddle mofo. Nice. All right, now this guy's weak to ice, pole arms, and daggers. Immune to lightning and employs lightning-based elemental attacks. Yeah, this is the end guy of the dungeon. I can't see what's going on.
Ready, guys? Oh, yeah.
No mercy.
Now let's hope he doesn't take off. Almost be dead soon. And there you go. That you get the flare, which is not going to be under quests, or it's going to be under daggers. right there. 337 damage. A mystic weapon of unknown origin. It finishes off a flurry of attacks with a devastating coup de grace. Alright, so that is going to be Iggy's, what's it called? Spear for the foreseeable future?
We're alive! Let's celebrate by eating something dead!
And that is the end of the vault. Going to take a while, or it takes a while to finish it. And I am going to sign out. See you on the next one. Fam 52. Later. Oh, and thanks for joining me, Castaway. Thank you. You were helpful tonight. Very helpful. Much appreciated.